اولا نحب اشكر اساتذتنا دكتور عادل ودكتور احمد بيه ودكتور ماهر ودكتور محمد جمال على الفرصه دي. النهارده هنتكلم على الارثروسكوبيك سب اكروميال ديكومبريشن ايذر تو اور نوت تو دو. سب اكروميال امبنجمنت از ذا موست كومن كوز اوف شولدر بين. ات اكاونتس فور اباوت 55% اوف شولدر اوردرز اند انفورشنتلي ذا موست كومن كوز اوف شولدر سيرجز اند ذيس ستيتمنت ماست بي كويستشنبل. Acromioplasty was first introduced by Neer in 1971, arthroscopic subacromial decompression by Ellman in 1987, and since then the outcomes have been reported to be consistently good. However, nowadays, after several and multiple studies, the literature may have another opinion. In our study, we will say how to diagnose impingement, and we made a systematic review from 2017 up till now about the subacromial decompression and the recent literature opinion to do or not to do, and what are the indications, and finally the scheme for operative intervention. Many of us see in our clinics that patient with a normal painful range عمل subacromial decompression عندنا او عند حد من زمايلنا, وبعد العمليه بقى عنده limited and painful range. This is because the type 1 complex regional pain syndrome or sympathetic dystrophy has a very high incidence in subacromial after subacromial decompression and may reach up to 11%. What are the faults done during diagnosis? First, the history. Some of the our small colleagues identify any shoulder pain without apparent cause as impingement. And also in the examination, we may not complete the examination, and the source of pain may be the biceps, and we proceed for subacromial decompression. And also the MRI, some MRI radiology consultants diagnose impingement directly. We see the report named impingement. However, although impingement is a dynamic process that occurs during motion, الراديولوجيست ممكن يكتب تندينوباثي, ممكن يكتب تندينوزيس, بس مش المفروض ان هو يكتب ان ده impingement, لان impingement دي clinical diagnosis. How to diagnose? معظمنا عارف الكلام ده. Pain with insidious onset exacerbated by overhead activities and night pain. وطبعا الimpingement test, النير impingement sign, والهوكنز test, والجوب test, والpainful arc اللي هو pain with abduction at 60 to 120. The X-ray has a very important role to see a cause such as type 3 acromion or calcific tendinitis. MRI, of course, and the nascent trend is the dynamic ultrasound to see the impingement during motion. We will say now the recent literature opinion from 2017 up to 2022. In the study made by Professor David Byrd et al. In the Lancet journal at 2018, he studied this arthroscopic subacromial decompression for shoulder pain. He made the study in a randomized control trial, three groups from 32 hospitals in the UK with 51 surgeons. هما قسم الجروبس دي لثلاثة جروبس. أول جروب عمل لهم arthroscopic decompression, تاني جروب مجرد diagnostic arthroscopy زي placebo, ثالث جروب عمل لهم no treatment. He found that الimprovement في الأوكسفورد شولدر سكورز مع الارثروسكوبيك decompression didn't differ من الناس اللي عمل لهم مجرد diagnostic scope. Although both surgery provide greater symptom improvement, ولكن then no treatment, يعني التو جروبس اللي عملوا منظار showed improvement أحسن من no treatment, ولكن الdifference ده was of uncertain clinical significance. In the Bone and Joint Journal in 2019, Rombach et al. Made a cost effectiveness analysis of the placebo controlled randomized trial. He found that the subacromial decompression is more costly than no treatment over 12 months. كانت يعني cost, very high cost, وفي نفس الوقت no clear evidence that it is cost effective. الفاس إتال in 2021 made a study about subacromial decompression for impingement. He found that there was no clinical relevant difference between decompression alone and conservative or placebo for pain and function at 1 year follow-up. Rachel et al. Made an astonishing editorial comment at August 2022 في الجورنال of arthroscopy. He said that arthroscopic treatment should no longer be offered to people with subacromial decompression. This opinion might be a bit astonishing. And also in the British Medical Journal, Professor Van Dyke et al. Said that he reached the guideline, that the guideline panel makes a strong recommendation against surgery. He said this opinion because the surgery did not provide improvement in pain, function, or quality of life compared with placebo and other options. However, frozen shoulder may be a common complication with shoulder decompression. Finally, Shuang et al. Made a systemic review and meta-analysis from inception to July 2019. He compared 7 randomized control trials with more than 600 patients. 300 patients made arthroscopic decompression and 300 were treated conservatively. He found no significant difference in shoulder pain or scores between both groups in long-term or either short-term follow-up. Nowadays, whether to do or not to do decompression surgery, from all the previous studies in the recent years, we should consider ourselves another time in the decision of operative intervention. What are the indications and when to do the surgery? Eric Homan et al. Said, يعني سؤال نسأله, هل مجرد MRI diagnosis ان في impingement نعمل impingement؟ لا. هو they said that impingement is a clinical diagnosis and the first line should be always physiotherapy and the indication for surgery is failure of non-operative for at least 6 months. This was also published in April 2022 in the Journal of Arthroscopy. Singh et al. Made a pre-operative scoring system to select patient for arthroscopic decompression. هو عمل 6 criteria, لازم نلاقي 5 منهم على الأقل عشان نقول ان العيان ده يعمل decompression. الست كريتيريا: shoulder pain with overhead activities, persistent symptoms for more than 6 months, improvement for more than 1 week after subacromial steroid injection, symptoms persist after at least 1 course of supervised physiotherapy, persistently positive Hawken test results, and finally radiologic changes of impingement. نلاقي حاجة في ال MRI سواء type 3 acromion عاملة degeneration, نخش نعملها, مش مجرد احنا هندخل نشيل برسة لان الكلام ده اصبح قديم. ومجاجي إتال also made similar criteria. He said that the patient must have the 4 criteria. He must have pain in the shoulders overhead, positive Hawkins test, temporary relief after 2 weeks of steroid, and finally another important radiologic evidence of impingement. برضو اللي بنقول عليه نلاقي حاجة هنشيلها, sclerosis, cyst, osteophyte في الجي تي أو في الأكروميوم. Finally, دال سكيم, it was published in the Journal of Arthroscopy in March 2020. Indications of arthroscopic subacromial decompression, هم حاطين كريتيريا عنيفة شوية, وده برضو يقول لنا ان احنا لازم نراجع نفسنا قبل قرار العملية. هم قايلين ال first the patient should have shoulder pain with no history of trauma, positive clinical examination, positive radiologic evidence, MRI and ultrasound, وبعد كده exclude other causes زي symptomatic AC أو biceps أو advanced arthritis أو referred pain من السيرفيكال, وده حاجة common جدا, و exclude history and clinical examination. وبعد كده احنا كده diagnose impingement, طب نعمله؟ لا, استنى برضه 6 شهور كمان بفيزيوثيرابي. Take home message: proper diagnosis, clinical or radiologic, conservative first to second to third, if surgery was done, arthroscopic examination for any other pathology, وcareful close post-op for up, ما نسيبش العيان 3 شهور بعد عملية ونلاقي نلاقيه stiffened, and rehabilitation to avoid stiffness. Thank you.